Hello everyone! In this quick video, we'll talk about using uDraper clothes with path tracing. Here we have an Unreal Engine 5.1 project with hardware ray tracing enabled. We also have a metahuman character with this dress. And have the garment component set up. Previously, we had an issue with incorrect shading of the fabric's backside when using path tracing. Here's how the backside looked in the previous version, when rendered in path tracing using an opaque material, the vertex factory set to geometry cache. To support the fabric's thickness with path tracing, we've recommended setting the vertex factory to local. However, with masked materials, the backside used to look black, while translucent materials didn't quite look correct either. Better than solid black, I suppose, but it's still missing the mark. In the current version, we resolved this issue, so let's take a look at how to set up uDraper's materials to use with path tracing. Here we have the latest version of uDraper, and switching to path tracing again, we'll see a problem with the fabric thickness. In the Draper garment component, Vertex Factory is set to geometry cache by default, and we've added an option for backface to either be embedded or separated. With the embedded backface, you'll have better performance, so we recommend it when you're not using path tracing. When using path tracing, we'll want to set backface to separated. The backface of the fabric now looks the same as the front. Let's check the translucency mode now. In the skirt material alpha section, set the transparency to translucent. The alpha on this dress is being generated with the alpha texture, and you could change the alpha masking to different elements or edit this alpha texture. The opacity min and max can adjust the levels of transparency in the garment. Just like that, once the sample's clear, we can see the alpha is now working beautifully. So now we can take full advantage of the path tracing capability with uDraper materials.